Welcome back for another Tiny Tots. This week, we are going to learn all about the letter I. But first, before we make our iguana book pet craft, I'd like to start you off with a couple of book recommendations. This first book, Manana Iguana, is a bilingual book, so it's written in both Spanish and English. And it's by Anne Whitford Paul, illustrated by Ethan Long. And this book is about an iguana who has his friends helping him plan for a fiesta at the end of the week. This book, Iguana Iguana, is by Karen Kaufman Orloff and David Cottrell. And this one is about a little kid who begs his mom for an iguana to have as a pet throughout the whole book. You'll have to read it though to see if she ends up giving it to him at the very end. Let's get started. Follow along on your practice sheet as we learn how to write an uppercase letter I and a lowercase I. To begin, for the uppercase I, we are first going to draw the vertical line. Second, we are going to draw the top horizontal line. And third, we are going to draw the bottom horizontal line. Repeat this as many times as you need to practice on your sheet. One, 2, 3. For the lowercase I, we are going to draw the vertical line, and don't forget to dot your I. 1, and dot your I. Again, practice as many times as you need. And there you have it. For a recap, 1, 2, 3 on the uppercase I, and for the lowercase I, 1, and dot your I. This week is all about the letter I. We've already learned what an uppercase I is and what a lowercase I is, but what other words begin with the letter I? I is for ice. I is for ice cream. I is for iron. I is for igloo. And I is for ink. In this week's kit, you should have received directions, a puzzle, which is also double-sided, glue dots, pipe cleaners, beads, googly eyes, a clothespin. Step 1. Take the shortest pipe cleaner and wrap it tightly until it makes a circle, leaving about 1 inch sticking out to glue on the clothespin. So take the pipe cleaner and twirl it around until it makes a circle, leaving 1 inch sticking out to then stick onto the pipe, the clothespin. Step 2, using a glue dot, stick 1 googly eye on the flat side of the circle you just created, the iguana's head. So we're going to take a glue dot, stick it onto the circle you just created, and stick on the googly eye. Step 3. Repeat step 2 on the opposite side of the iguana's head. And there you have it, the iguana's head. Step 4. Hold the clothespin in your hand, opening the clothespin. Wrap the second pipe cleaner around the middle of the clothespin, creating the first set of iguana legs. So you're going to open it up, insert the pipe cleaner,
and wrap it around, creating the first set of legs. Step 5. String the beads onto the third pipe cleaner. Curl the ends of the pipe cleaner into small circles so that the beads stay in place. So we're going to place our beads on. And curl the edges so that the beads do not fall off. Step 6. Using a glue dot, attach the head of the iguana to the top of the clothespin. So we're going to place a glue dot onto the top, and the top is where it opens. And add the head, creating the iguana's head. Step 7. Using a glue dot, attach the pipe cleaner with the beads onto the back of the clothespin, creating the tail. Curl the pipe cleaner a bit to give it a tail-like appearance. So we're going to curl it a little bit, give it a little bit of a bend. We're going to stick a glue dot onto the back of the clothespin. And we're going to stick the tail on. Step 8. Wrap the last remaining pipe cleaner around the end of the clothespin over top of the glue dot where you just attached the tail. This will create the second step of legs. Wrap it around. And there you have it, the second set of legs. Step 9. Bend the ends of the middle pipe cleaners to make them look more like legs. So you're going to grab your iguana. Bend one set of the legs, and then we're going to bend the back legs. And there you have it. Your book buddy iguana. Once you have completed your book pet iguana, stick it on books as you read. You can place it on the corner, on the side, wherever you would like. We'll see you next week on J is for Jellyfish.